स्टूडेंट, वेलकम वंस अगेन टू माय यूट्यूब केमिस्ट्री चैनल अमेजिंग केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस। आई एम डॉक्टर रोहित चक्रवर्ती, एन एजुकेटर बाय प्रोफाइल, अ सीनियर साइंटिस्ट। सो दिस वीडियो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इज कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड्स फॉर क्लास 12th स्टूडेंट्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द पार्ट वन। हियर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ओनली इन ब्रीफ about the coordination compounds, what are coordination compounds, its definition and few examples, and later on I will upload more part of this chapter. So here few examples of coordination compounds you can see. So first we are going to discuss about the Werner's theory and its main postulates. So first of all, I would like to request all the students to take a snapshot so that you guys will read out and make notes of these. Okay, तो सभी बच्चों को बोलूँगा एक बार आप लोग सब इसका स्नैपशॉट ले लें, सो दैट आपको प्रिपरेशन अच्छे से हो जाएगी. सो what इज Werner's थ्योरी एंड द मेन पॉस्टुलेट इज दैट फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज इन कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड मेटल शोज टू टाइप ऑफ लिंकेजेस, दैट इज प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी. ठीक है, तो आई थिंक दिस स्लाइड इज सेल्फ एक्सप्लेनेटरी, आई एम नॉट गोइंग इन डिटेल. So you have to write down these points and you have to memorize these points and you have to make your concept clear. Okay. Second point is that the primary valencies are normally ionizable and are satisfied by the negative ions. All right. So negative ions anions होते हैं, positive ions ये मैंने पहले भी in detail बताया हुआ है carbon ions and carbocations के बारे में. The secondary valencies are non-ionizable and these are satisfied by a neutral molecules and negative ions. The secondary valence is equal to the coordination number and is fixed for the metal. Okay. Fourth point is the ions or groups bound by the secondary linkages to the metal have a characteristic spectral arrangements and corresponding to the different coordination numbers. So what is the difference between a double salt and a complex salt? So here first we are going to discuss about the double salt. What are double salts? Double salts are complexes. They differ in the fact that the double salts dissociate into simple ions. However, complex it get dissociated into simple ions completely when dissolved in water. However, complex ion does not dissociate into ions. So this is the difference between the double salt and the complex. So a few examples of double salt. First is carnelite, that is KCl, MgCl2 and 6 molecules of water as a water of crystallization. Second one is Mohr salt, very important. These formulas are very important. So bachcho, please aap log inko likh lijiye, take a snapshot and do practice. I always say for the chemistry subject, aap logo jitna practice karenge utna aap logo ke concepts clear honge. And try to practice, write down all these formulas which are very important. Mohr salt, FeSO4, NH4 whole twice SO4 and 6 moles of water. Okay. And then the last one is potash alum, very important again, KaLSO4 whole twice and 12 moles of water. Now talking about few definitions of important terms, that is coordination entity and few examples here. So take a snapshot and let me read out the definition. What is coordination entity? A coordination entity constitutes a central metal atom or ions bonded to a fixed number of ions or molecules. So here I have given an example of coordination identity entity. You can see here that cobalt, so there are 3 moles of molecules of chloride ions and 3 molecules of ammonium ions. Okay, so other example is nickel tetracarbonyl, nickel platinum dichloride ammonium, then hexacyanoferrate, hexamine cobaltate. Okay, so in this way we are going to now definition of some more important terms, that is what is central atom and ions. So here you can see a few examples, and the first one is central atom is nickel, second is cobalt, third is iron. So here the cations are Ni2+, cobaltate 3+, and the iron in 3+ valency. So in coordination entity, the atom or the ion to which a fixed number of ions or groups are bounded in a definite geometrical arrangement around it is called the central atom. For example, the central atom or ions in the coordination entity, jaisa ki maine aapko bataya, in the first one that is nickel 2+ ion, in second is cobalt, and in third one is iron. So these central atoms or ions are also referred to as Lewis acids, because they can provide the electron, they are coming in the, there is a positive charge over it, that is why they are known as Lewis acid, they can accept the electrons. they are having the positive ion, positive charge over it, so they can easily accept the electron. That is why they are known as Lewis acids. Now, what are ligands? So the ligands are the ions or molecules that are bound to the central atom or ions in the coordination entity, and these are called ligands. These may be simple ions such as chloride ion. So these are carbon ions basically, and so small molecules, neutral molecules like water, ammonia, and a larger molecule like, here I've given an example, that is NH2CH2CH2NH2, that is ethylene diamine, or even macromolecules such as protein. Also here these are example of some amine compounds. So when a ligand is bound to a metal ion through a single donor atom, the ligand is said to be unidentate. So these are the examples, unidentate, like chloride ion, water and ammonia. Similarly, when a ligand can bind through two donor atoms, the ligand is said to be bidentate. Oxalate ion ki main aapko baat kar raha hu, C2O42 negative is oxalate. Second one is ethane 1,2 diamine. So these are known as bidentate or didentate. And when a ligand can bind through several donor atoms are present in a single ligand, the ligand is said to be polydentate. Example is ethylene diamine tetraacetate, EDTA. So when a di or polydentate ligand uses its two or more donor atoms to bind in a single metal, then it is said to be a chelate ligand. So basically, yeah, bachcho, isme main example batata hu, aapko example se zyada acha samajh mein aayega. The number of such ligating groups is called as denticity of the ligand. Such complexes called chelate complexes tend to be more stable than the simple complexes containing the unidentate. So isme kya hota hai, bidentate or polydentate hota hai. To ligands kya hai, 2 ya 3 isme donor atoms hote hai. So bonds become more strong, so there will be a binding on a single metal atom through two or three donor atoms ke through isme bonding strong hoti hai via ligands. So here I have given an example of chelating ligands like trisoxalatochromate 3 ions. Okay, oxalato kyun bola isme, kyunki agar aap check karenge, so there are three oxalate ion. So the term used to be for 3 is tris, then oxalato chromate 3 ions, because yahan pe 3 negative diya hua hai, so we have to write down 3 ions. Okay, so this is the formula for trisoxalatochromate 3 ion. Now hexadentate ligand, the example is, here you can see there are 6 points of attachment to the calcium metal, so it is known as ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, EDTA. Here you can see the complex and the complete formula, and this is the formula for the EDTA. Okay, on the left hand side you can see the formula of EDTA, and how there is a formation of chelate complexes. On the right hand side there will be a formula. So ligands which can ligate through two different atoms is called ambidentate ligands. Examples of such ligands are nitrate ion and thiocyanate ion. Nitrate ion can coordinate either through nitrogen or through oxygen and to a central atom ion. So these are similarly called, thiocyanate ion can coordinate through the sulfur or the nitrogen ion atom. So bachcho, aap logo ko samajh mein aayega, isme both sides se atom, either through nitrogen or through oxygen. Similarly, in case of HCl negative, it can coordinate through the sulfur or nitrogen atom. So a few more important definition terms, that is, what is coordination number? The coordination number of a metal ion in a complex can be defined as the number of ligands or donor atom to which the metal is directly bonded. Here I have given an example in the complex ion like hexachloroplatinate and tetraamine nucleate ion. The coordination number of platinum is and nickel is 6, because yahan pe chloride ion 6 present hai, theek hai, so there will be 6 for the coordination number in the first complex, and in the second one there are 4 ammonium ions, so the coordination number will be 4. So the number of ligands attached to the central metal atom is equal to the coordination number. I hope aap logo ko bachcho samajh mein aaya hoga. So this is the last slide for today's video, and in next video I will upload more topics on this, that is the coordination sphere, the last topic for this video. The central atom ion and the ligands attached to it are enclosed in a square bracket. Here you can see, and is collectively termed as the coordination sphere. The ionizable group are written outside the bracket and are called counter ion. For the example, in the complex, that is hexacyanopotassium, hexacyanoferrate, and the coordination sphere is Here you can see FeCN6 जो हमारे ब्रैकेट के अंदर है, दैट स्फेयर इज नोन एज कोऑर्डिनेशन स्फेयर एंड द काउंटर आयन इज द पोटेशियम आयन. ओके, सो आई होप आप लोगों को बेसिक समझ में आ गया होगा बच्चों. इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल अपलोड मोर टॉपिक्स एंड रिगार्डिंग कोऑर्डिनेशन पॉलीहेड्रन ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर. सो दीज आर द टॉपिक्स विच आई एम गोइंग टू अपलोड. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज़ कीप वॉचिंग ऑल माई वीडियोज़ एंड